best about our city and what's best about public services. They need our support. This motion is the start of a campaign that we need to have to make sure that we get funding back for the police of this city so they can protect us and keep us from harm. That's what the motion's about now, and we support it.
Seconding the motion. Are you wishing to speak now? Right, Councillor.
Thanks, Lord Mayor. So earlier in the agenda, I asked the Council to endorse the City Safe annual report. And this report basically sets out how the City Safe partnership is working to reduce crime and social behaviour in Liverpool. And it's a good report. It highlights some really good examples of the impact that our work is having across the city. But what it also highlights, which is more worrying, is that we have seen a very real increase in crimes reported to the police. The City Council partnership with the police continues its hard work, but it is getting harder and harder to do more and more with less and less resources. And make no mistake, the criminals of the city are taking full advantage of police resources being stretched. They are using these gaps as opportunity to wreak havoc in our communities. There have been 50 shootings in the city this year, and as the Mayor has already said, we think enough is enough. And we also shouldn't forget that these police cuts are compounded by the cuts to other services, including our own youth services team, from this very cruel and uncaring Tory government. And it means that we now have to focus on crisis management rather than proactively working with young people and those who are on the fringes of getting into crime and stopping them getting further down the road. So the Mayor and more recently MPs of the PCC have been asking time and time again for those increased resources to actually be able to do our jobs and keep our city safe. They were in London just yesterday, as the Mayor said, making the case, and while the conversations were reportedly positive, the government have yet to make any commitment to providing Merseyside with the properly funded police force it needs and deserves. A few years ago, many of you will remember, Theresa May said the police were scaremongering and crying wolf when they warned that there would need to be a paramilitary police approach after cuts to their budgets. And she still stands by that, even after bringing in the military to support the police after the attacks in London and Manchester. She's a failed former Home Secretary in a bubble all her own, and she still says the police should just get on and do the job. But what she doesn't understand is they already are. Merseyside Police are consistently praised for being one of the best in the country for tackling serious and organised crime. Before the cuts, Merseyside Police were able to dedicate officers to the proactive disruption of those involved in gun and gang-related crime. And following a peak in 2012, that work paid off, with year-on-year decreases for the following 3 years. And by 2015, the number of firearms discharges had virtually been halved. They know how to tackle it, but they cannot get the job done if they don't have the resources to do it. It's really quite simple. And despite the incredible work of the officers in Liverpool, because of the lack of consideration and unfair treatment from the government, I really fear for the future of our communities. So I would urge everyone in this chamber to support the motion and ask that all our communities get behind the campaign for increased funding so we can get a fairer and safer deal for our city.
Thank you, Councillor Squirrel. I'll call Councillor Radford to move his amendment. If he has a seconder. Thank you.
I'd just like to move very quickly the amendment, which is just highlighting, whilst there has been an increase in police reports, I think naturally it's underrated, because I'm going to be honest with the Board Councillor, I'm finding residents who were previously reported particular instances of minor crime vandalism are now having to wait so long on the 101 system. They can't get through, they give up and don't report. So I think actually the increase you referred to doesn't reflect a real increase in crime. And I think that should be worrying. The other thing that does bother me is once upon a time we used to have incredibly large public neighbourhood meetings. And in my own district, I know it wasn't true of all districts, sometimes we had up to 120 residents discuss police issues publicly at quarterly meetings at sometimes more. Nowadays, residents are told to go online to express their concerns over policing issues. While recognised for a lot of the old generation, they're not particularly comfortable, and nor do they know that they have to look online to report complaints. So I think there is some serious issues about that. But I concur, regardless of whether the amendment is accepted or not as an amendment, I really concur with all the comments. And I'd just like to pull two examples this month that really bring home all the comments that the Mayor made were actually true. This afternoon, I met a couple who have now put their house up for sale. They had confronted some people drug dealing in the back of their communal area to the rear of their property. And whilst they were asking just to restrain by Kelly, they were attacked by the machete. Three other householders have moved out. So far, the authorities are not suggesting that the private landlord will be forced to evict the culprits while it's going through. That is something I will take back and speak to police and landlord licensing, because I don't believe people should be expected, because it was witnessed by a whole neighbourhood, a machete attack in the middle of the afternoon. The other incidents that brings home to truth that Mayor's comment being very truthful. Whilst meeting one day, we had previously had an incident where